example of what you can do with your life for the good, for the bad. You have earned your stripes. You have worked and battled and overcome adversity. So I love the way you are shaping it, because we are all right now in a situation which has given tremendous concern, depression. We don't know what's going to happen, what's going to come. So I want everyone who is listening and watching to understand what Bernard is saying, because when I feel that I have a problem, I'm going to think about Bernard Hopkins, how he overcame all these problems that he just described to be a champion in the ring and to be a champion in life. This is wonderful. What have you done in these months of isolation, of pandemic? What do you tell others to do?
What I tell others to do, to stay mentally and physically motivated, to challenge yourself, challenge your body and exercise, challenge your mindset and during reading and studying and go back and look at the things. And these are things that I've been doing. Mr. President, you know, boxing is a grueling schedule, as you know. When you get a chance to sit down and actually be home and actually go through drawers and closets and stuff that accumulate by traveling and emptying your pockets and emptying your suitcase and just leaving it there and it get put up here and it get put up there, and you lose track of things because of this pandemic. You must take something that seems a dark cloud, and guess what? You must make those adjustments like we make in boxing, like we as fighters make in a ring. Those adjustments is we in a situation that never been put on us in this country or this world ever. And those adjustments has to be made sooner than later, because if anyone can make an example, the WBC, myself, and others who love the sport of boxing, organizations or entities outside of boxing that understands that you must keep your mind fresh. You must keep your sanity. I mean, your sanity, and still be willing to continue to move forward, and don't become stagnant. Don't become a puddle of water that will evaporate as time go by if that water doesn't flow. You must continue to flow. And that means you, first of all, you in your house, in your surroundings. I got a chance to go over a lot of things, find a lot of things that I misplaced, my boxing stuff, my future of maybe doing my own docu-series, maybe doing my own next, my own story on film, my own documentary. I got a chance because of this pandemic is to do what? Make those adjustments that we talk about, Mr. President. We talk to people about it, and now we're being challenged at the highest level that we can imagine, where it affects everybody, whether you on this status of finances or power or control in a way of running a business or running an organization or running, I will say, certain parts of the world. We all in this together. We all are living under guidelines to stay alive and to stay safe, but stay relevant. And to stay relevant is you must continue to keep the mind, body, and spirit intact. And that's what I've been doing, Mr. President, is letting myself and reminding myself and the energy that's around me that this is a fight. This fight doesn't have any rounds. It ends when we end it. And that means that you must be strong, you must be supportive, you must have prayer, you must have good ethics of work in spite of adversity. This is what we talked about. Now we gotta face it, and let's see who will grab the flag and say, let's be successful in this, because we got an enemy. And our opponent is right now. Our opponent is right now. And anybody that think different than that, I would love to talk to them and let them know by doing this interview, by doing this convention, which never been done to my knowledge in my 28, 29 years of boxing in the ring. But now that we are in this situation, we don't have to stay in this situation. If we protect ourselves, we think about the other fellow neighbor, fellow family member, who you going to each house with, who you going to talk to. You take care of yourself. You be conscious of the guidelines that's been put to us that, Mr. President, you mentioned, I mentioned on certain outlets of social media, we must understand you survive and you win. Part of my strategy in boxing was you survive and then win. It wasn't the opposite. It wasn't win and then survive. It was you survive first and then you win. And that's my strategy in life. And that's, Mr. President, what kept me out of anyone's penitentiary for 30 plus years with a legacy that you mentioned less than an hour ago. It's so passionate and so motivating to me. I have a story to tell for anybody that's willing to listen. Let's not become stagnant. Let's keep moving. Let's look at this virus as a serious opponent that we must knock out. We must KO it and receive the WBC championship belt once we do it.
You know, I've been taking a few notes, thinking of how I'm gonna remember this conversation with you, but it's endless.
It's on tape, you got it.
I'm just so admire what you are, what you become. You know, survive, then win. That is it. We have to survive, and we have to do what boxers do. Protect yourself at all times. It's so easy to understand that COVID-19 is a reality. It's not a something that, it's not a penalty to anyone. It's just a reality. How to survive, we all know. Wear the face mask, keep the distance, wash your hands, protect yourself when...
That's surviving, Mr. President. That's surviving. You said it. I said it, but you repeated it. It's survival. That's the survival mechanism. Survival is not falling to the demise of the situation, whatever that situation is. We have an invisible opponent. I'm going to say that again, Mr. President. We have an invisible opponent with a name called Corona. Can you imagine me fighting in a ring with an opponent that's hitting me, but I can't hit it? So what do you got to do in that situation? You have to protect yourself. Keep your chin down, your mask on. That's your chin. See, your chin, the mask.
And you don't go toe to toe. You outbox him, right?
You navigate around the enemy. You navigate around the enemy, and that's a survival mechanism. And then you win. And winning comes in time in this situation. In this situation, it comes in time. It will pass. And I'm glad I'm going into this segue right here, because guess what? It will pass. Like many disasters in our world that we overcame, it will pass. And until then, that's the survival mentality that we have to have.
I want
survive
to
survive and then win. Survive and then win.
Following this line that we are getting into,